always dance, hurry up and give me the microphone before I bust on my pants. The mad author of anguish, my language polluted. Onyx is heavyweight.
It's still undisputed.
It took the words right out my mouth. I walk a mile in my shoes. I pay so many dues. I feel used and abused, and I'm so confused. Now, excuse me, for example, I'm an inspiration of a whole generation. And unless you got 10 sticky fingers, it's an imitation, a figment of your imagination. But wait, it gets worse. I'm not watered down, so I'm dying of thirst. Coming through with the scam, foolproof plan. B-boys make some noise and just scam.
Okay, so this ritual, the way that we're reading it, it's calling out for the subject to be strapped down to the table.
Okay.
There is some liquid that was in an old beaker like ceramic kind of dish.
Okay.
So basically we strap you down. We pour that down your mouth and your nose. Okay. And are you familiar with the beetle cactus?
The beetle cactus? No, yeah. I can't say I am. Sorry.
Okay. We're actually going to have to place several pins of that all over your body, and then we have to peel it open and rectally it goes. We put the peeled open section into you. And then we chant, which I won't be part of because I don't speak any pagan, but then we chant those, the words on the tablet, and then supposedly that's what starts it all. Are you comfortable with all that?
Well, I can tell you one thing from a little bit that I read on the pagans really warned, they were made out to be, evil worshippers, but actually it wasn't like that. It was actually the opposite. So what I'm going to say to you is, you know what? I'm leaning towards let's get this done.
Okay.
Let's get this done.
Okay.
There's one more thing I was going to say to you. What was it? I kind of lost my chain of thought for the moment. Oh, is there a particular reason? Well, I can imagine, I can only think of what the reason is, but I'm going to ask you the question. I saw the posting, the ad on Craigslist, and it said it was an experiment and a study for bodybuilding and weight loss.
That is something that we basically had to kind of say. Ultimately, if it does work, I believe you will definitely have weight loss and much more muscle. I'm nearly certain of that. Based on any image of Satan I've ever seen, he's a very strong person. So if it works, we're not being misleading. But ultimately, we had to say that because Craigslist isn't going to allow me to put an ad on saying we are trying to summon the devil.
Doctor, I want to say these words to you.
Okay.
If this experiment was to take some patience and be done, and if the outcome of this experiment with me is somewhat comes out to be very positive and very fruitful at some aspect and some level for myself as well for you gentlemen or you people on the other side of the scientific side, I just want you to know that I get this funny feeling, and I don't expect you to answer what I'm going to say because I don't expect you to tell me, but I get this strange feeling, this feeling that this is something going on a much deeper high level of some type of scientific and government level. And you know what? That's so good for me because I've had this burning desire for such a long time to become a part of something at that level for many, many years. And this might be it. So I just want to tell you that if for now you're satisfied with what you've heard from me and what you are thinking, then I would just like to say to you, let us proceed on to the next step.
Okay. I mean, I can't say that you're far off. Obviously, there's things that I can't discuss with you. I'm sure you understand. I have some confidentiality agreements.
Sure.
So there, you're not far off, though. Again, I'm very impressed by your abilities to pick up on some of the things that I haven't told you. It's kind of spooky a little bit because we might be onto something here.
It's okay. Don't be too spooked, because actually, if what I'm feeling that's going through my body and my mind and my brain right now, this is actually starting to become the beginning of a dream come through for me.
Excellent. That's the kind of participation that I need. So if you'd like, I believe...
Is that going to be here in New York, or is it going to be somewhere else?
Yeah, that's the information I'm looking on right now. That's the reason we're replacing them in New York. I'm actually looking for the address, because I think I've made my choice. I'm very impressed with you. I've talked to about 70 people before I've talked to you, and it's just been like an interview. You'd think that they're applying for a job. With you, it's been, like I said, a little bit different. So I'm going to go ahead and give you an address.
Because I'm the guy for you for this, believe it or not. I'm telling you. This is not by accident.
Okay.
This is years in the making for me.
All right.
This is all the stuff that I have read throughout the time here and bitching here and the little things I've been doing because I've wanted to make myself better in some kind of way on an enlightened level.
You want to be part of something bigger than yourself. I understand.
Absolutely.
That's why when they were asking what doctors would be willing to try to see if Satan could be risen from the grave, I wanted to be part of it, because if this could be something, it would prove so much. I mean,
okay,
it's amazing.
Well, guess what?
So, yeah, go ahead.
Let me just say this to you.
Okay.
Think of it this way. When you have hot and cold,
yeah,
they're one and the same. The question is, where does cold begin and where does hot start? They're actually opposites of each other, like yin and yang. You have love and hate. They're one and the same. They are one and the same, and exactly, they only differ in degrees of extremes. So now I'm going to hit you with this one.
Okay.
And you being a man of science, you don't have to answer me, but this is going to ponder you much after we hand up the phone.
Right.
You have Christ and you have the Antichrist. They are one and the same. They vary in degrees in extremes. That's all I'm going to leave you with.
Okay.
You come to your own determined conclusions.
We will right after this test. That's going to tell me everything. Well, Paul, I definitely want to pick you for the test. I mean, how soon can you be available?
You tell me, because I have a couple of appointments, so I don't know. You tell me when you were looking to schedule me, because this way I can tell you that I have a couple of appointments this Monday morning, and I don't have any other appointments until the following Monday.
Okay. Tuesday at 9 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, so 9 o'clock your time in the morning. Could you come to an address for me? I'm pretty sure it's not too far from you because it's right there in New York.
Okay, hold on. Let me get a pen.
Okay.
And I have a pad here so I can write this address down.
All right.
Give me a moment, please. I'm ready. Go ahead.
It's actually, on the outside, it is a men's warehouse. But
hold on.
Yep.
Go ahead.
So it's 2021 Bartow Avenue, and it's a men's warehouse. But if you go inside and let one of the people know, there's a back room and then a basement that's used for below the radar type of medical studies, basically.
Yeah. This is starting to sound like some super secret service kind of stuff, but no problem. Bartow Avenue is over there by Co-op City. I know exactly.
We're not
going
to try to summon the devil in the middle of, you know, New York Hospital.
I understand, you know, that, but anything is possible. It's okay. Yeah.
So it's at the men's.
It's okay. I'm with you. You have my full cooperation.
Okay. In the men's warehouse, it's also the Emergent Savings Bank is right on that same building. So that's how you'll know you're in the right place. You go in, you let somebody in there know that you're looking for Dr. Ryan Token.
And hold up, Dr. Ryan Token? Yeah.
T-O-K-E-N.
Is that T-O-K-E-N?
Correct. So
okay.
You let them know that you're looking for Dr. Ryan Token and that you're supposed to meet. And they call it Cavador 4, and that's the basement. Cavador 4 is the basement. So you let them know that, and they should take you in the back after that, and then you'll go down a flight of stairs. Either that or they'll use the freight elevator, but they'll probably just use the stairs. It's quick.
Should I come dressed in any particular way?
Yeah, you'll just come dressed how you normally would. I don't know.
Comfortable is fine. Casual and comfortable is okay.
Yeah, because we'll probably have to put you in kind of the ritualistic clothing of the time. So I'm not entirely sure what that'll be because that'll be part of the historians will try to do that.
Okay.
But you'll probably be dressed kind of like if you thought of how Jesus was dressed. So you probably look a little like, you know, him with like kind of a toga type of thing on. But so it doesn't matter what you wear there, really. I mean, it's really up to you. Basically, if you just show up there.
This is Tuesday at 9 a.m. you said I'd have to be there?
Yep, Tuesday at 9 a.m.
Okay.
If they try to act like they don't know what you're talking about, keep in mind it's a little bit of a secret. Just let them know. Let them know that the password is cactus.
Say that again?
The password is cacti. If they try to act like they don't know what you're talking about, tell them the password is cacti.
Cacti?
Yeah,
C-A-C-T-I.
Yeah, it's like the plural of cactus. Cacti.
C-A-T-E-I? That's what you said, right?
Yes.
C-A-T-E-I.
No, C-A-T-I. Cacti.
Oh, I see.
Yep, it's the plural for cactus. So
okay.
All right. So that's all you got to do, and I think we're all set. I think we can try this thing. So why don't you go ahead and repeat back to me what the instructions are for Tuesday?
Okay. I have 2021 Bartow Avenue. Okay. Your name is hold on, because I have people standing around and walk away. Dr. Ryan Token.
Correct.
And you said that it's Capador 4, which is the basement.
Yep.
And you said that the password is cacti.
Yeah, if they act like you don't remember, because they may, don't go up to them and say that, you know, don't say password is cacti. Go up to them and say that you're here to see Dr. Ryan Token and say, say the thing about the basement. And then if they don't seem to know what you're talking about, just tell them the password is cacti. And that should get them.
And these are people that are on some kind of a security desk or something when I walk into the building or the warehouse?
No, it's the men's warehouse, so they'll just look like they're, you know, selling suits and they're just regular people work there. But this is where we do our testing on the east side for different type of things that aren't quite things that you can't walk into a hospital and do.
I'm just telling you, I'm loving it every more and more every time. Okay.
Okay.
You got me.
All right.
If there's any chances, you got my phone number, but unless I'm dead, I will be there.
Okay.
All right.
Can't wait to see you, Paul. So, thank you.
I can't wait to see you, believe me. Have a good one.
You too.
Bye-bye.
Mr. Dr. Token, this is Paul Rivera. I'm just calling to confirm tomorrow, Tuesday, the 13th of August, 9 a.m. appointment on 2021 Bartow Avenue. So give me a call, 347-694. Confirming the appointment for tomorrow morning. Thank you. Mr. Dr. Token, I'm here. It's 8:30 a.m. It's Paul Rivera. I can't seem to get past the front door, and I hope this is some kind of joke or something, because it's raining. I really don't appreciate it. So give me a call, 347-694. There's a woman in there that they don't open till 10 o'clock. There's no dust. It's a men's warehouse. I said that, yes, I know. He gave me the information. I haven't said any type of password yet. But what's going on?
Yes, Mr. Dr. Tolkien, this is Paul Rivera. It's 9:30. I'm going to make another attempt to go in to 2021 Bartow, the men's warehouse. I will be mentioning the CAFDAM 4 and the password, but if this is just a fabrication of everything, well, you got me. I was really looking forward for it. Anyway, give me a call if anything, if this is really for real. Thanks a lot. Bye.